first I thought you quit, and that's it. So that's why I pushed it so hard.
Yeah, but that was a misunderstanding on the phone.
Yeah, but then when you came back, it became an adventure again. And it's not a race anymore. The race is dead now, on Stelvio Pass. All I want to do now is have a great adventure. And I'm happy about that.
And now we can just go on, and I can just ride with you.
Now it's leisure again.
You call it leisure, for me it's...
Sorry. Happy campers.
I was so surprised when he said, don't ride less than 210. Please don't do that.
It's the first time I hear something like that from you.
You're starting to like this. Now when there's no stress anymore, when you can just ride however you like.
I realized that I can do actually 220Ks. Yeah, it takes an hour longer to catch up with him, so, or maybe two sometimes, but I can do it.
This is really about the ride only. Yeah. And the ride today was just awesome. And that's exactly what I realized today. I just felt it. Damn it. Ah.
I hadn't even eaten yet, so I just ate his rests. The pesto rest with the hot water. And that was the best soup in my life, actually. So all this, like the bikes, the block, Erik, myself, this is all happening. And it is, I mean, it's really happening. There is nothing planned. There is just the start and the end. And I'm doing this on an own creation. That's, I mean, is there anything better? Is there anything better? I mean, it's...
Actually, a 7 kilo carbon fiber bike.
Ah, fuck it, man.
Going up Stelvio.
I think our bikes are the perfect mirrors of ourselves. Recep's bike is a total disgrace to anybody, but I love it, and it's so much Recep. And my bike is just like a peacock. It's a total poser. I just did it for attention, so I could focus on myself. Riding, when people focus on my bike instead.
It's so much you.
It's so much me. I know. I would consider this to be an adventure because we never know what's to come. We are not planning more than 5 minutes ahead or maybe 1 minute ahead. And we don't know anything about the countries, we don't know anything about the roads or weather conditions, or that's adventure to me. It's like unplanned, spontaneous traveling. But that's the good thing about developing stuff. Machines like we do, because you really need to put them under strain and test to realize what you can improve. And I don't think there's any other better way than going on such a race and spend 16 hours a day on the bike.
I mean, right now we are educating it. We are showing this bike how life works, kind of like you would educate your kid. It's on a tour now, and it is about to prove that it can withstand that life and manage it, and it's doing good so far. It's making me proud, actually.
Paradiso.
Wahnsinn.
This is nice.
Imagine the winner of the Transcontinental Race. He finished yesterday in 8 days, and we're gonna finish in 15 days. So we still take
less than 8 days, actually.
Yeah, we still take double the amount of time he didn't take. That's what we're doing.
But he never had a dip. He never had a coffee in the morning.
Oh, your hat. Oh. Your scarf. Oh. See ya. Oh.
Your glasses. Sorry.
What's my glasses?
You look so drunk.
Yeah, it's broken.
We ride the same pace, but Recep stops at every gas station. Ah, gotta send the fax. I gotta buy a drink. And you only do one thing at a time.
Yeah.
I stop at one gas station and do everything, and then I continue.
Why that?
Because I need focus. I need to set my focus. I want to get into that tunnel, you know, where you just ride. And I would have stayed in that tunnel for 2 hours. I want to sit on my bike and just be gone, like I'm hypnotized. I just want to ride and ride. You're like, yeah. And then I got to stop here. And then you forget to ride your bike. And then it's like,
no,
I got to
stop
here.
I have another interpretation.
Yeah?
Yeah. For me, or to me, all those stops are part of the ride.
Yeah. Yeah, they are. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I understand that.
Without those stops, the ride, yeah, that would make the ride to a race, actually.
Yeah, yeah. We're just saying that we have two different ride styles.
No.
Where I focus on the finish line more, And you focus on the ride, what's around you.
Yeah.
And we don't really have a problem with that, any of us, but it just...
In the end we meet, right?
In the end we meet and we... I finish faster than you. Melon?
I got more.